Hi, have you ever wondered what are diagnostic criteria for PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome? Well, stay tuned because I'm going to be going through them in this video. So now, for all of us who already have PCOS, or for those of you who are actually wondering if you have PCOS, I'm going to try to explain the criteria in the easiest possible way. So, we have three criteria to be diagnosed with PCOS. I'm going to say in a minute how we are actually diagnosed. First criteria that we are going to go through is actually ovulatory dysfunction. And there are a few things that might be happening in your body to actually indicate that you have that problem. So what it is? Usually it's irregular or absent periods. Of course, irregular and absent periods can be happening for many, many different reasons. So this is just one of the criteria, as I said, and no ovulation. So you can either have ovulation sometimes, irregularly, irregular periods, no periods whatsoever, and that will actually indicate that you have some sort of ovulatory dysfunction. This can also be tested with your levels of your hormones. Sometimes you can be prescribed or asked to do some sort of urine tests to check if you're ovulating, and then your doctor is gonna be able to tell if you're ovulating or not. Now, the second criteria is gonna be clinical or biochemical hyperandrogenism. It sounds very complicated, but what is it actually? First of all, your doctor can look just at the signs of high estrogen in your body. And what are the most common signs? If we talk about testosterone levels and high testosterone, because we have two types of androgens, we have testosterone and we have also our adrenal androgens. So if we talk about our testosterone, this is acne, hirsutism, which is excessive hair growth, for example, on the places that are usually associated with male pattern. So it can be your chin, it can be chest, it can be over your bum, on your back, and so on. Yeah. And the other one is hair loss. There can be many, many reasons for hair loss, but if you have one or few of them, it can indicate to your doctor that you have high testosterone levels or high androgen levels. Now, the other thing can be actual high androgen levels in your blood work. It doesn't necessarily mean that your doctor is going to prescribe you the tests. What I would recommend is definitely ask your doctor to prescribe you a full blood testing to check both your testosterone levels, free testosterone levels, and to check your adrenal hormones as well. Because hormones like DHEA, for example, and hormones like cortisol, they're our adrenal stress hormones, can also cause all the hyperandrogenism results, and they can also be high in our body. Now, the third criteria is actually very, very simple for polycystic ovarian syndrome. We will have polycystic ovaries on ultrasound test. That is the tricky one, because you know that the name of the syndrome is polycystic ovarian syndrome. However, very important thing to know is that you have to have two out of three of that criteria. This criteria is called Rotterdam Criteria, and that has been in play since 2003. Now, why am I mentioning it now? Because as I said, you can have polycystic ovaries on ultrasound test, and the test usually is gonna be made either with outside ultrasonogram, but more possibly through internal ultrasonogram when your doctor can look at your ovary a little bit closer. So you don't have to have polycystic ovaries to have polycystic ovarian syndrome. I know, it's weird, right? So why that is the name of the syndrome? Well, scientists are actually thinking about changing the name of that syndrome from polycystic ovarian syndrome, because not all women have polycystic ovaries. You might have everything that is connected to it. You might have very common insulin resistance. If you haven't watched my videos on insulin resistance, I'm going to link the playlist up here, so make sure you watch them. You can have hyperandrogenism, which I will also link before. I have a whole playlist about high androgen levels and how to treat them as well. And you can have polycystic ovaries, yeah? But you don't have to. So, scientists are debating right now whether the better name for polycystic ovarian syndrome would be metabolic reproductive syndrome. Because that also encompasses everything that happens in 70% of women with their insulin resistance and actually how their cells work. So in my opinion, I think metabolic reproductive system is much better name for polycystic ovarian syndrome. But make sure you like this video, subscribe and click the notification bell to be notified about future videos. And please let me know in the comments, which two of those three do you have? Do you even know? Did your doctor discuss it with you? Let me know in the comments and I'll see you soon. Bye.